What's up, everybody, and welcome to an all-new episode of Casters of Horror. I'm Chris Mess.
I'm Shane, and this week we get tangled up in Cobweb.
The Cobweb.
Yeah.
Yeah, so this movie just recently came out.
And if you've never heard of it, neither has anybody else.
Which sadly, it didn't get a whole lot of fanfare.
No.
Didn't get a whole lot of advertising.
Nope.
Which was sad. And what's odd? Well, we'll get into all that. This movie just recently came out in the theaters sparsely.
Yeah.
And then was put out onto streaming this last week. Not long after it'd come out into theaters either.
No.
This was written by Chris Thomas Devlin, who also wrote the Texas Chainsaw Massacre back in 2022. My voice went out. 2022. It was directed by Samuel Bodin, who had done. Let's see what all he had done. He did a miniseries called Tank, Batman Ashes to Ashes, which I assume was a short of some sort. Another TV show called Lazy Company. So he's done some TV stuff, it looks like, and some shorts. This stars Lizzie Kaplan, who you guys she's been in tons of stuff. She was in the History of Sex, Mean Girls, Now You Can See Me Too, Hot Tub Time Machine, Cloverfield, Fatal Attraction, Party Down, Castle Rock. She's been around. True Blood, she was in that for a short while. And also stars Anthony Starr. A little play on words there. Starring Anthony Starr, who you guys might know as Homelander from Du Bois.
Yep.
He was also on a show called Wish You Were Here and Outrageous Fortune from his home country of New Zealand. So he's a Kiwi. Now, something that you may not know about this, Shane, and I'm interested to see if you did know this or not. Not only was Homelander in this from The Boys, but this film was produced by Evan Goldberg, Seth Rogen, and James Weaver, also Josh Fagan. But all three of those guys are actually the guys who kind of started The Boys.
Yeah, really?
Yeah. So kind of explains why he's in this thing here. But yeah, Seth Rogen, man, Evan Goldberg. So their production team is the one who put this out.
Okay.
So I'd like to see a lot more.
They should have spent maybe some of their budget on marketing.
Yeah.
That would have been good.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
I mean, I saw the trailer for this like maybe a month or so ago. I don't know. I just remember, like, I saw it and was like, well, that's going on my, you know, on my radar
to watch list. Yeah.
Yeah. So, but I didn't realize that it was already coming out because there's been no advertisement for it at all.
See, I saw it come up, a little just blurb about it up on Instagram a few months back. I screenshot it. I'm like, this is one I'm going to have to keep a lookout for, and hadn't heard anything about it. Until all of a sudden Uncle Creepy gets on and he's like, oh, if you guys haven't seen this, it kind of flew under the radar. You got to check it out. And I'm like, how did I miss this? Yeah. You know? And I was like, when did it and how did it? And then I saw a couple other people talking about it. And the next thing you know, it's coming out on streaming. And I'm like, heck yeah, we got to check this thing out. So we made sure we jumped on this as soon as we possibly could. I'm not gonna waste any time. This, to me, as far as horror goes, probably number one that I've watched this year.
Yeah.
Nice. I'm just going to come right out and say it right here at the beginning. I'm not going to bury any leads or anything like that.
Yeah.
This movie was incredibly well done from start to finish. The creepiness factor in it is just unparalleled.
Yes.
It's a story about a little boy who's starting to, he's hearing things in his room. His parents are telling him, oh, don't pay attention to it. It's all in your mind, all this. But is it really? Is it really all in his mind? And so that's about all I'm going to say about it. And then this movie just spirals out of control. I mean, it has you going, wait a minute, is it or isn't it? Is he going crazy? Is he not? What is happening? And it keeps you on the edge of your toe, or it keeps you on your toes for like the whole film from start to finish. The kid did an incredible job in this. He was played by, let's pull him up here, Woody Norman. Has he been in anything else? He was on the show Him, Current War, Electric State, Come On, Come On. Oh, he's in The Last Voyage of the Demeter, which unfortunately I've heard is not doing well.
Yeah, same.
But I'm still going to see it. You guys are still going to hear our take on it. So that's definitely going to be one that we're coming up with. Well, Shane, what did you think of this film? I've just been talking nonstop. I obviously was excited about it. What were your thoughts?
I'm right there with you. As soon as I finished this one, I was thinking like this. I think this might be my favorite one we've watched this year.
Yeah.
You know, absolutely. I will have to go back through and kind of look at everything else I've watched. But, you know, one thing that I had pointed on Twitter, and you kind of already said just how creepy it is. Everything about this movie is creepy.
Yeah.
Right. And I had noted, you know, horror movies, they tend to be disturbing or scary, you know. Yeah. You can attribute a lot of words to horror movies. There's one thing that I don't think that very many of them do well, and that is just having an overall creepy tone.
Absolutely.
This one does it from start to finish, and everything about it. You know, everything from the shots, you know, the camera work, the music, just the
facial expressions.
Yes. The acting is so good. This one, I cannot believe that it has flown under the radar like this. It is so good. It is so creepy.
What's exciting to me about this, though, is this is going to be one of those films that's going to be this hidden gem cult classic.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Since it didn't get a whole lot of, it's going to get the word of mouth out there. I'm hoping.
Yeah.
I'm hoping we can help do that, too. But absolutely. It's going to get that word of mouth out there of how good this movie is. Like, to me, this is one of those films where it wasn't over the top gore. It wasn't over the top anything. It was so balanced. This film was so well balanced that to me, It was one of those movies where I wanted to say to somebody immediately, you have to watch this.
Yeah.
You have to check one out. And if I'm going to go back, if there was one movie right now that I would say that would be like, what movie would you play on Halloween over and over? This would be the one that I would say, I'm going to play this one on Halloween.
Yeah.
This is going to be my go-to Halloween film, because it was just enough of this creepiness gets you in the spirit of just dread and horror, but not so over the top that it's just like, okay, I can't take that anymore.
Yeah. And again, there comes that word creepy, but it is, I mean, this film is just,
it's unsettling.
It's very unsettling. And I think what you said about nothing about it being over the top is spot on.
Yeah.
And if anything about it was over the top, then it wouldn't be creepy. Right. Yeah. And it wouldn't have that same, that tone that I often look for in films and so rarely find, in my opinion. And there's obviously a lot of films that I really love that aren't like this, but man, when I get one that just the entire movie leaves you like you don't want them to do this thing they're about to do, no matter what it is, you know?
Oh yeah.
Or get out of where you're at and go. That's it's
and there are some turns that this film takes that you're just like,
oh yeah,
they went there, they did this, or I can't believe that happened. You know, it's like,
yeah,
wow. And, you know,
and you know, there were some things I was like, you know, just from being a, you know, a horror lover and just a story lover, there are going to be some things in there that are like, I kind of saw them coming, but then there's plenty of stuff too where it didn't go the direction that I thought it was going to go.
Yeah.
In many ways. So yeah. This one was I want to say it was a surprise, but again, I saw the trailer for this and I immediately knew I wanted to watch it. I guess I am surprised that I'm surprised by how much I liked it, I guess.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah. So
it did not disappoint. I had not seen the trailer for it. All I had seen is just the poster it shocked me beyond anything that I imagined. So
I think you might be better off going into this one not really knowing what you're getting into.
Yeah.
And ironically, I don't know, one of the posters actually spoils more than the trailer did. Very weirdly. So if you've seen the poster
that I end up using for the thumbnail for this too.
I don't know. That said, this is absolutely one of my favorite films that we've watched this year. Probably one of the better ones that's going to end up coming out this year, I think.
Yeah, so. I agree. I just did the thing on Twitter where it was, what has been your top films for this year? And this one is on my top film so far for this year.
Yeah, for sure.
So it was incredible. Brilliant.
I think that this is one where, if you asked me that question later in the year, this is probably one that I'd be able to immediately put on there.
Yeah.
And then like all the others, I'd have to go through and look to see what I consider.
Oh yeah.
You know, my best, my favorite. Absolutely. So
absolutely. Well, let us know what you guys think. Have you guys checked it out yet? If not, get on it. Check this film out. It is on Amazon. You guys can check it out there and stream it. It is a rental, but it is worth the buy. This film. If you can get your hands on a copy of it that way, buy it, purchase it. It's well worth having the copy of it. This is one you're going to go back to.
Yeah. And this is actually one that I really hope they do a physical and like a steel book for. I would love to get a steel book. I don't know what the art would be, but it wouldn't matter. I think it would look amazing.
Yeah, don't really care. It's gonna be one of those ones that it's worth having. Yeah. And like I said, I'm gonna end up. This is gonna be on my Halloween watch list. Yearly, for sure. I would have to say. So let us know what you guys think. Put it down in the comments down below. Make sure while you guys are there, make sure to hit like and subscribe and put down there if there's any other movies that you say is on your Halloween list. Yeah. Like, what's your go-to Halloween movie? So put that one down in the comments down below. Check out Cobweb. It's brilliant. Tell your friends, tell your family, tell somebody, because this movie is, it's so good. Check it out. But anyway, that's it for this week. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Until next week, I'm Chris Mess.
I'm Shane. And we'll see you.
Get the hell out of here. We'll see you guys.